These are the top 10 stories that drove conversation this week. As the fuel scarcity worsened, PAGASA threatened to go on indefinite strike, considering the FG's resolve not to do anything about previous agreements. The strike began on Monday but was called off same day after a meeting with the FG. Still on the matter, NNPC said it intercepted 144 truckloads of fuel diverted by marketers, who they accused of sabotage. Corroborating the statement from the Minister of State for Petroleum Resources, Ibe Kashikwu, the NNPC said the fuel queues will clear off by the weekend. That is this weekend. The PDP has, however, asked that we reprimand President Buhari for the persistent fuel scarcity, considering he is the Minister of Petroleum. Former Police Chief Mike O'Kairo, in an interview, explained the reason for the establishment of the Speciality Robbery Squad, SARS, how it became useful, how it spread and how the ideals of the police unit was upturned. This was a reaction to the #SARS campaign, which lawyer Femi Fala also reacted to. On the flip side to the campaign, PCRC in Cross River gave reasons the police unit should be kept alive and reformed, not scrapped like people are demanding. President Buhari celebrated his 75th birthday, got accolades but also some political comments. The governor of Ekiti, Ayodele Feyos, said Buhari should not contest in 2019. Former President Goodluck Jonathan said his place is guaranteed in history. World football figure Thierry Henry visited Nigeria and was crowned the Igwe of football in Lagos. Nigerian singer Burna Boy finally submitted himself to the police, after evading same for a while. He was then arraigned for sending hoodlums after a colleague in the music industry, Mr. 2K. The approval of $1 billion from the Exceed Crude Account, ECA, for fighting Boko Haram in northeast Nigeria was clarified by the Vice President, Yemi Osinbajo. He said the money is not only meant to fight insurgency but will be used to improve security in the country. Meanwhile, Governor Feyos and the Governor of Zamfara, Abdulaziz Yari, are at loggerheads over the approval of the funds. The Senate has since questioned the approval of the withdrawal but the President, Bukola Saraki, said the APC does not spend money with due process. In another development, Niger Delta militants are not happy with President Buhari over the money, accusing him of double standards. The main opposition party, the People's Democratic Party, PDP, held a convention, although marred by irregularities and grumblings, but Nigerians thought they were ready for the 2019 elections. First of all, the party accused President Buhari of planning to build prisons for its members in 2018. Then, a group made up of five men opened a new secretariat for the party, calling it Fresh PDP. But Feyos said they got it all wrong. Then they came again saying, President Buhari wants to be the sole candidate in 2019, that's why they, APC, want to cause a crisis in our party. After fighting for several months, the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC, said the Nigeria Financial Intelligence Unit, NFIU, will be granted autonomy on January 1. We have allowed NFIU to go, the EFCC boss, Ibrahim Magu, said.